All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is David King. He is a Senior Vice President at Magna Mining. And David, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm good, Steve. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thanks very much. And some interesting results out from the company today, talking about your Crean Hill project, and more specifically, the 109 footwall. So tell me a little bit about the 109 footwall.
Yeah, so the 109 footwall zone is what's known as a footwall style ore body. It's a breccia-hosted zone of mineralization, low sulfide, high PG, platinum, palladium, gold, precious metal mineralization that extends back out into the footwall of the historically mined nickel copper contact ore body at Crean Hill.
Okay, and so you've released some initial results from there. So are you happy with what you guys are seeing so far?
Very much so, yeah. Drilling from the previous operators was relatively wide space, and this zone is kind of modeled as a broad envelope of mineralization. I think we know from our drilling in 2022 and earlier this year that there are zones of, although it's overall a low sulfide zone, there are more massive to semi-massive veins that can be very, very rich in precious metals within the overall broad envelope of mineralization. So today's results, I guess, are from a series of very short holes near surface where the zone comes to surface, and relatively tightly spaced compared to the historic drilling in the area. And they were designed specifically to help us determine the distribution and try and figure out the continuity of these high-grade, more massive sulfide veins within the overall envelope of mineralization.
And you found quite a bit in there. You found, nickel, you found copper, palladium. You found a lot of stuff.
That's right. The typical 109 zone as a broad envelope is relatively low in copper and nickel, but high in precious metals. But like I mentioned, we do know that there are narrow, massive veins that can be quite rich in nickel and copper, as well as PGs.
Okay. So I understand in reading the news release that you're looking at bulk sampling next. So is that the next phase of this, is to get a little more in the ground, so to speak?
Yeah. So, I mean, we're going to work with the data we just collected with this short hole program, probably update our geologic model. And that'll also help us plan a surface bulk sample. So we can go in, blast out some rock, map the walls and the floors, and really get a test of our geologic model and begin to understand the zone even better, right? And reconcile against any resource estimates we have in that area.
And possibly going underground in 2024, I hear?
Yeah, we're thinking about that, and that's our next plan. That would be the next step, I think, after our surface program. Yeah.
All right. It's going to be a busy one for sure. Dave, thanks very much. Good update and interesting results. We look forward to continue to follow things as it unveils, okay?
Very good. We hope to talk to you again soon with some other good results.
All right. Look forward to it. David King, the Senior Vice President at Magna Mining.